Let's continue on with our discussion about variables, and I'm going to jump and leave this example for a second and jump into another example. So I'm going to create another class, public class, variable types fun, opening brace, closing brace, public static void main string args, opening brace, closing brace. Okay, so what we want to do is look at the different types of variables that we have available to us. We already saw that we had an integer, an int type, that we said age equals 25. Okay. The integer can hold, well, integers, right? Hold numbers, and the size of the integer is 32 bits. Now, if we take our calculator here and we say we have a in memory, we have each bit can either be on or off, right? One or a zero. That's two different options. And so we say we have two different options and 32 digits in it. So 2 to the 32nd is the number of possibilities, starting out with all zeros, then 0000001, 0000010, 0000011, and so on. So this goes back to numbering systems. It's kind of beyond the scope of the discussion in our class. But the point is, if I go out to memory and I reserve 32 bits of memory, that will give me a little over 4 billion different options that I can store. And then we reserve the first bit for to represent whether it's a positive or a negative number. So actually it's 2 to the 31st power, because one bit's either going to be on or off for negative or positive number. And so what we get is basically 2 billion positive to 2 billion negative. That is the size of the number we can store when we have an integer. Okay? So an integer is 32 bits, can store plus or minus approximately 2 billion. And not that you need to know this specifically for what we're doing, but this I like to kind of give the bigger picture of what's happening, right? And so that's what we're looking at. Well, what if I need to store a number that's bigger than 2 billion? For example, if I'm storing how many people are on the Earth right now, I don't know what the exact number is, you know, 6 plus billion, that's not going to fit in this number. So what do I do? Well, in Java, we have another type called a long, and the long gives us 64 bits. Well, 64 bits is going to be huge, so I can do it. I wonder if this calculator will even do it. 2 to the 64 is that number. Really, really, really big number. So there's thousands, millions, billions, trillions, quadrillions, whatever comes after that. Really big number, that's the point. And so longs are if we need to store really, really big numbers. Okay, so that's 64-bit, really big, whole numbers. Didn't need to emphasize that. Numbers, okay. Well, the problem is, even if we have an int, if we try and say an int, an age equals something like, you know, when we talk about kids, babies, you talk about them in terms of months. So you have to say, how old's your baby? He's 18 months. Well, 18 months is actually 1.5 years old, right? But if I try and compile this, I'm going to get an error. Well, I got to save it first and then compile. And it's going to tell me possible loss of precision. Int variables are not meant to store decimal numbers. You're going to lose some precision. I can only store the one part of it, and you're going to lose the 0.5 part. So I'm giving you an error saying you're going to lose precision if you try and do that. So what can we do if we want to store decimal numbers. Well, what we'll generally use is something called a double. A double age can store 1.5. If we try and compile and run this, then it doesn't do anything, but it will store that just fine because doubles are built to hold decimal numbers. So a double is 64 bits that allows for really big or really small numbers, floating point numbers, okay? That's what a double holds. Now, why double? That seems like kind of a strange name. Well, before doubles, we had something called a float, which also holds decimal numbers, works a little bit differently, and it was 32 bits. But the thing is, and you can still use floats, but it used to be that we were dealing with, like, you know, when I started into the computer world, we had like 32 megabytes of memory. And so we were really limited on how much space we had in memory. If we look at, you know, all the variables start getting loaded, every program that you're running starts creating variables, then that can be a problem. But now we've got huge amounts of memories, and so we've kind of shifted the balance to be more about convenience. And so what I'm getting at is most of the time we use doubles. Most of the time we use ints and doubles when we're dealing with numbers. We don't deal with longs unless we need to, generally. So a lot of the times we're using ints and doubles. Well, what else is there available to us? Well, there's something called a byte, and it's exactly what it sounds like. A byte is 8 bits, which means it can hold a number 2 to the 8th, 256 is what it can hold. And again, because the first bit is reserved to say whether it's a positive or a negative number, what it can actually hold is 2 to the 7th. So it can hold 128 on the negative side and then 127 on the positive side because 0 is one of those numbers. 256 different options total. And so that's a byte that, again, if we're trying to save memory and we don't need a number that's going to be any bigger than that, then we can use a byte for that. So a byte is an 8-bit number that goes negative 128 through 127 positive. Okay, so that's another type. And then we have a couple of other types that we use on a pretty regular basis. One is a Boolean type. I'll do it this way first. So a Boolean type, and a Boolean type is an on or an off. It holds a true or a false. And so I can say Boolean, was there an error? And that's true. Or false, whatever I want to set it to. But that's the only thing it can hold, is either a true or a false. Now the funny thing about a Boolean is it really only needs a 1 or a 0, right? To store whether it's true or false, but it actually is an 8-bit number as well, because it just turns out it's easier to store all zeros or all ones in an 8-bit number than it is to try and single out a single bit. Less work for the computer. So we use Booleans to represent true or false values. And then the next one we'll talk about is a char variable. Now, a char variable holds one character, and the character is based off of the ASCII chart. And so there's 256 different options in the ASCII chart. And the char is just one of those characters. One character, one 8-bit character that is an ASCII character. So it could be an A, uppercase A. It could be a lowercase A. It could be a plus sign. It could be a 5. It is one character out of the ASCII chart, and that's all it holds. And so when we set a char, we'll say char letter equals an A. And we do it in single quotes when we're dealing with a char. So char letter equals A, and that is the character. That's all it holds. And it has useful applications that we'll see, but it also has some limitations, obviously, that it is only one character. So I can say it's an A, I can say it's a 1, I can say it's a plus sign, but it's only storing one character at a time in a char. Okay? And so the other one that we'll mention is something called a string. And a string is kind of different than the other characters. We'll talk about this in a little more detail. But the string is not what we call a primitive Java data type. Because the major hole here is we've got lots of variable types that we can store different things in. But what happens if we want to store a sentence? Well, initially, when you wanted to store a sentence, you stored a bunch of chars together, all in a row called an array, and that would be a sentence. But to just make life a little bit easier, a string type was created. Now, this one's a little bit different because this is a capital S. This is the only one out of all these different variable types that we've looked at that has a capital letter. Everything else is a lowercase letter. And that's because the string itself is a mini program. It's its own type, but it works just like any other variable, which is really nice. And so I can say string sentence equals, this is a sentence. Compile that, and it compiles fine. If we run it, it's not going to do anything. But if I go down and say system.out.println and then print sentence, then it will take those words that are in there and print those out, because that's what's been set out in memory. So the string is actually an array of chars, and I can't remember right offhand how many, if it is or if it has a set number, 256? I don't know, but anyway, it's a bunch of chars put together in a string of chars. And that's why we call it a string. Okay? All right, so recapping quickly, our variable types that we have available to us are an int long, that's for whole numbers, a float and a double for decimal numbers, a byte for smaller numbers, a boolean for true and false values, a character or a char to hold one character, and a string to hold words. And with those variables, we can store basically everything we need to run our programs. There's some exceptions, and we'll talk about those later on as well. But those are the variable types that we have available to us in Java. All right, so we'll continue on talking about some other aspects of variables in the next video. Spencer out.